Daily Evening Prayer. Saturday, June 29th, 2024. Jesus spoke to them, saying, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. Almighty and most merciful Father, we have erred and strayed from your ways like lost sheep. We have followed too much the devices and desires of our own hearts. We have offended against your holy laws. We have left undone those things which we ought to have done, and we have done those things which we ought not to have done. And apart from your grace, there is no health in us. O Lord, have mercy upon us. Spare all those who confess your faults. Restore all those who are penitent, according to your promises declared to all people in Christ Jesus our Lord. And grant, O most merciful Father, for his sake, that we may now live a godly, righteous, and sober life, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Grant to your faithful people, merciful Lord, pardon and peace, that we may be cleansed from all our sins, and serve you with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord. The Lord's name be praised. O gladsome light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun, and our eyes behold the vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Lord, I call upon you, hasten unto me, and hear my voice when I cry out unto you. Let my prayer be set forth in your sight as incense, and let the lifting up of my hands be an evening sacrifice. Set a watch, O Lord, before my mouth, and keep the door of my lips. O let not my heart be inclined to any evil thing. Let me not be occupied in ungodly works with those who work wickedness, lest I eat of such things as please them. Rather, let the righteous smite me, and in your loving kindness reprove me. Let not the oil of the unrighteous anoint my head, where, while I live, I will pray against their wickedness. Let their rulers be overthrown in stony places, that they may hear my words, for they are sweet. Let their bones lie scattered at the mouth of the grave, as when the plowman scatters the earth in furrows. But my eyes look upon you, O Lord God. In you is my refuge. O, do not cast out my soul. Keep me from the snare which they have laid for me, and from the traps of the evildoers. Let the ungodly fall into their own nets together, and let me ever escape them. I cried unto the Lord with my voice, even unto the Lord I made my supplication. I poured out my complaints before him, and showed him my trouble. When my spirit was in heaviness, you knew my path. In the way wherein I walked, they had secretly laid a snare for me. I looked also to my right hand, and saw there was no one who would know me. I had no place to flee to, and no one cared for my soul. I cried out to you, O Lord, and said, You are my refuge and my portion in the land of the living. Consider my complaint, for I am brought very low. O deliver me from my persecutors, for they are too strong for me. Bring me out of prison, that I may give thanks unto your name. When you show me your loving kindness, then shall the righteous gather around me. Hear my prayer, O Lord, and consider my supplications. Hearken to me for your truth and righteousness' sake. Enter not into judgment with your servant, for in your sight shall no one living be justified. For the enemy has persecuted my soul. He has smitten my life down to the ground. He has laid me in the darkness, like those who have been long dead. Therefore my spirit faints within me, and my heart within me is desolate. Yet I remember the time past. I muse upon all your works. Indeed, I meditate on the works of your hands. I stretch forth my hands to you. My soul gasps for you as a thirsty lion. Hear me, O Lord, and very soon, for my spirit grows faint. Hide not your face from me, lest I be like those who go down into the pit. O let me hear your loving kindness in the morning, for in you have I put my trust. Show me the way that I should walk in, for I lift up my soul unto you. Deliver me, O Lord, from my enemies, for I flee unto you to hide me. Teach me to do the thing that pleases you, for you are my God. Let your loving spirit lead me forth into the land of righteousness. Revive me, O Lord, for your name's sake, and for your righteousness' sake. Bring my soul out of trouble. Of your goodness, slay my enemies, and destroy all those who afflict my soul. For I am your servant. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the prophet Daniel, beginning with the 8th chapter, the first verse. In the third year of the reign of Belshazzar the king, a vision appeared to me, Daniel, subsequent to the one which appeared to me previously. I looked in the vision, and while I was looking, I was at the citadel of Susa, which is in the province of Elam, and I looked in the vision, and I myself was beside the Ulai Canal. Then I raised my eyes and looked, and behold, a ram, which had two horns, was standing in front of the canal. Now the two horns were long, but one was longer than the other, with the longer one coming up last. I saw the ram butting westward, northward, and southward, and no other beast could stand against him, nor was there anyone to rescue from his power, but he did as he pleased and made himself great. While I was observing, behold, a male goat was coming from the west over the surface of the entire earth without touching the ground. The goat had a prominent horn between his eyes. He came up to the ram that had the two horns, which I had seen standing in front of the canal, and rushed at him in his mighty wrath. And I saw him come up beside the ram, and he was enraged at him, and he struck the ram and smashed his two horns, and the ram had no strength to withstand him. So he hurled him to the ground and trampled on him, and there was no one to rescue the ram from his power. Then the male goat made himself exceedingly great. But once he became powerful, the large horn was broken, and in its place four prominent horns came up toward the four winds of heaven. And out of one of them came a rather small horn, which grew exceedingly great, toward the south, toward the east, toward the beautiful land. It grew up to the heavenly lights and some of the lights, that is, some of the stars. It threw down to the ground, to the earth, and it trampled them. It even exalted itself to be equal with the commander of the army, and it removed the regular sacrifice from him, and the place of his sanctuary was overthrown. And because of an offense, the army will be given to the horn, along with the regular sacrifice, and it will hurl truth to the ground, and do as it pleases, and be successful. Then I heard a holy one speaking, and another holy one said to that particular one who was speaking, "How long will the vision about the regular sacrifice apply, while the offense causes horror, so as to allow both the sanctuary and the army to be trampled?" Then he said to me, "For 2,300 evenings and mornings, then the sanctuary will be properly restored." When I, Daniel, had seen the vision, I sought to understand it, and behold, standing before me was one who looked like a man. And I asked the voice of, and I heard the voice of a man between the banks of the Ulai, and he called out and said, "Gabriel, explain the vision to this man." So he came near to where I was standing, and when he came, I was frightened and fell on my face. And he said to me, "Son of man, understand that the vision pertains to the time of the end." Now while he was talking with me, I was dazed with my face to the ground, but he touched me and made me stand at my place. And he said, "Behold, I am going to inform you of what will occur at the final period of the indignation, because it pertains to the appointed time of the end. The ram which you saw with the two horns represents the kings of Media and Persia. The shaggy goat represents the king of Greece, and the large horn that is between his eyes is the first king. The broken horn and the four horns that came up in its place represents the four kingdoms which will arise from his nation, although not with his power. And in the latter period of their dominion, when the wrongdoers have run their course, a king will arise, insolent and skilled in intrigue. And his power will be mighty, but not by his own power, and he will destroy to an extraordinary degree and be successful and do as he pleases. He will destroy mighty men and the holy people, and through his shrewdness he will make deceit a success by his influence, and he will make himself great in his own mind, and he will destroy many while they are at ease. He will even oppose the prince of princes, but he will be broken without human agency. And the vision of the evenings and mornings which has been told is true. But as for you, keep the vision secret, because it pertains to many days in the future." Then I, Daniel, was exhausted and sick for days. Then I got up and carried on the king's business, but I was astounded at the vision, and there was no one to explain it. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For he has regarded the lowliness of his handmaiden. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he that is mighty has magnified me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is on those who fear him throughout all generations. He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in the imagination of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones, and has exalted the humble and meek. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent empty away. He, remembering his mercy, has helped his servant Israel, as he promised to our fathers, Abraham, and his seed forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, beginning with the 22nd chapter, the 23rd verse. And as they were shouting and throwing off their cloaks and tossing dust into the air, the commander ordered that he be brought into the barracks, saying that he was to be interrogated by flogging, so that he would find out the reason why they were shouting against him that way. But when they stretched him out with straps, Paul said to the centurion who was standing by, "Is it lawful for you to flog a man who is a Roman and uncondemned?" When the centurion heard this, he went to the commander and told him, saying, "What are you about to do? For this man is a Roman." The commander came and said to Paul, "Tell me, are you a Roman?" And he said, "Yes." And the commander answered, "I acquired this citizenship for a large sum of money." And Paul said, "But I was actually born a citizen." Therefore, those who were about to interrogate him immediately backed away from him, and the commander also was afraid when he found out that he was a Roman, and because he had put him in chains. Now, on the next day, wanting to know for certain why Paul had been accused by the Jews, he released him and ordered the chief priests and all the council to assemble, and he brought Paul down and placed him before them. Now, looking intently at the council, Paul said, "Brothers, I have lived my life with an entirely good conscience before God up to this day. But the high priest Ananias commanded those standing beside him to strike him on the mouth." Then Paul said to him, "God is going to strike you, you whitewashed wall. Do you sit to try me according to the law, and in violation of the law, order me to be struck?" But those present said, "Are you insulting God's high priest?" And Paul said, "I was not aware, brothers, that he is a high priest, for it is written, 'You shall not speak evil of a ruler of your people.'" But Paul, perceiving that one group were Sadducees and the other Pharisees, began crying out in the council, "Brothers, I am a Pharisee, a son of Pharisees. I am on trial for the hope and resurrection of the dead." When he said this, a dissension occurred between the Pharisees and Sadducees, and the assembly was divided. For the Sadducees say that there is no resurrection, nor an angel, nor a spirit, but the Pharisees. No, but the Pharisees acknowledge them all. And a great uproar occurred, and some of the scribes of the Pharisaic party stood up and started arguing heatedly, saying, "We find nothing wrong with this man. Suppose a spirit or an angel had spoken to him." And when a great dissension occurred, the commander was afraid that Paul would be torn to pieces by them, and he ordered the troops to go down and take him away from them by force and bring him into the barracks. But on the following night, the Lord stood near him and said, "Be courageous, for as you have testified to the truth about me in Jerusalem, so you must testify in Rome also." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace, according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and a life everlasting. Amen. O Lord, be with you, and with your spirit, let us pray. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. That this evening may be holy, good, and peaceful, we entreat you, O Lord. That your holy angels may lead us in paths of peace and goodwill, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may be pardoned and forgiven for our sins and offenses, we entreat you, O Lord. That there may be peace in your church and in the whole world, we entreat you, O Lord. That we may depart this life in your faith and fear, and not be condemned before the great judgment seat of Christ, we entreat you, O Lord. Almighty God, whose blessed apostles Peter and Paul glorified you by their martyrdom, grant that your church, instructed by their teaching and example, and knit together in unity by your Spirit, may ever stand firm upon the one foundation, which is Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. O God, your never failing providence sets in order all things both in heaven and on earth. Put away from us all hurtful things, and give us those things that are profitable for us through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. O God, the source of eternal light, shed forth your unending day upon us, who watch for you, that our lips may praise you, our lives may bless you, and our worship on the morrow give you glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Keep watch, dear Lord, with those who work or watch or weep this night, and give your angels charge over those who sleep. Tend the sick, Lord Christ, give rest to the weary, bless the dying, soothe the suffering, pity the afflicted, shield the joyous, and all for your love's sake. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all, for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplications to you. And you have promised, through your well-beloved Son, that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will grant their requests. Fulfill now, Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.